Hey everyone, in this video, we are going to show how you can use Chainlink VRF in your smart contract on Polygon. We start with Chainlink's VRF documentation, link will be in the description. Here, in Generate Random Numbers in your smart contract, we have this link. Click on it and we'll be redirected to another page with an example contract. This is our starting point. To get a random number through Chainlink, we need to start by inheriting VRF consumer-based contract. Next, in the constructor, we need to put in the contact address for VRF coordinator and link token. We will also be needing key hash and fee for the specific chain. To get all this, we go back to the documentation page and scroll down. Now, click on contract addresses. Here, you can find the required info for all the supported chains. For example, we will deploy our contract on Mumbai testnet, so we copy all the values for it and replace it on our contract. Next, we have two functions, getRandomNumber, where you can request a random number from Chainlink VRF, and fulfillRandomness function, which is callback from when getRandom function generates a random number. With all of this set up, let's deploy our contract. Next step is to send some link to our contract. This would be required as fees for the VRF. On testnet, we can go to Mumbai testnet faucet and retrieve some link on our address and then transfer it to our contract. Now with everything set up in the Remix GUI, let's test this out. We will click on get random number and then wait a bit. The process isn't immediate, so make sure any functionality that depends on retrieval of the random number is performed in fulfill randomness function. After a while, we should have our random number stored in public variable random result. You are recommended to have a retrieve link function in your contract as well, so you can get back any remaining link from the contract. If you want your random numbers stored mapped to a unique ID, you can make some basic modifications here. Fulfill randomness function returns random value along with request ID, so you can map the random number to the request ID. Also, you can map the request ID to the message.sender in getRandomNumber. This way, you can allot a random number to every user who calls the function. Also remember, fulfillNessRandom function is a callback function, therefore its message sender is always going to be VRF coordinator address and not the address that requested the random number in the first place. So you need to make your functionality with that in mind. That would be all for this video, and we'll see you next time.